thanks for tuning in today. My name is Kayla Snyder, and I'm the Marketing and Recruitment Specialist for the Faculty of Environment. I'm here to tell you a little bit more about the Environment and Business program to help you decide if it's the right fit for you. So let's get started. So why pick Environment and Business at Waterloo? The Faculty of Environment at the University of Waterloo is one of the oldest and largest faculties of its kind in Canada. When the faculty was founded over 50 years ago, it was based on a dream that we continue to chase today, making the world a more sustainable place, environmentally, socially, and in terms of economic prosperity. We're on a mission to do something better for the world. We're recognized globally for our leadership in climate action, and the Environment and Business program that I'm chatting with you about today is the only one of its kind in Canada. As leaders in environmental education, we see an emerging trend, the growing need for professionals with both business acumen and environmental knowledge. Companies need to figure out now, more than ever, how to implement clean and green manufacturing and business practices. Cities, which are responsible for almost 70% of global energy-related CO2 emissions, need to adapt to and mitigate climate change with smart technologies and good advice from industry professionals. And it's not just us taking notice. Consumer demand for sustainable business practices are on the rise. Take a look at this example from BlackRock, which is the world's largest investment management corporation. They've committed to becoming the global leader in sustainable investing and are moving to having sustainable portfolios as standard operating procedure and increasing access to these options. This also means that the environment and environmental technologies will be big business. It's expected that up to $23 trillion in opportunities for climate and climate-smart investments by 2030 will open. Clean energy is already a big portion of the Canadian economy, accounting for 3% of our GDP. That's around $57 billion. And it's growing faster than the rest of the economy. Plus, by 2026, we expect 57,000 Canadian environmental professionals to retire. That means huge opportunities await our graduates. So what does this mean for you? Environment and Business uniquely positions its graduates for these emerging roles. In it, students learn the foundations of a business degree: economics, finance, accounting, management, and marketing. But they're also prepared with an additional environmental education, including field ecology, human geography, and environmental research techniques. You'll also take integrated courses that merge these two areas. This shows you exactly how businesses can be both sustainable and profitable. This is a skill set that is crucial and sought after in this growing green economy. It's a one-of-a-kind program that produces forward-thinking and savvy graduates that are uniquely positioned for career success. Here's an overview of our program structure. You can see the business, integrative, and environment courses that you'll be taking over the course of your degree. Here's what your first year schedule will look like. As you can see, you'll start taking the three streams of the program right from day one. Business, environmental, and integrative courses are built into your schedule. You'll also have enough room for one elective. This is a great opportunity to explore an area you're interested in, like a second language, political science, philosophy, music, many, many more. The choice is yours. As you progress through the program, you'll have more choices around the kinds of environment and business courses you'll take. Here we have the theme electives. These are areas that we organize our courses around. As you move forward, you can select what's of the most interest to you to give you a deeper understanding of the subject matter. By the end of your degree, you won't just have studied the skills and tools that I've listed here, you'll actually have put them to good use during your co-op terms and working with industry professionals. In your fourth year, you'll work on a unique capstone project for 8 months. Developed in collaboration with your team, you'll work with an industry partner to create a research project that helps them integrate sustainable practices into their business. Our students have worked with organizations shown here, but each year our list of partners continues to grow and change. We love to highlight the partnership with Live Nation. Students worked with them to help minimize waste at performance venues. Co-op is a huge part of being an environment and business student, so let's talk a little bit more about how it works. you'll start co-op in the winter term of your second year. In the previous term, you will start applying for jobs through Waterloo Works. You'll apply to things that are of interest to you and to roles that you feel suit your skills and abilities. Because of the array of skills that environment and business students bring to the table, there will be lots of different types of jobs for you to apply to. However, here's a short list of roles that our students have held for your reference. There are lots of great advantages to being a co-op student at Waterloo. Here are a few that I'd like to highlight for you. First, you'll graduate with up to 20 months of work experience. This will give you a great leg up when you're looking for your dream career after graduation. Next, you'll earn between $38,000 and $85,000 over the 5 terms to help you pay for school. These are average earnings for environment co-op students. Next, it's a great opportunity to grow your network. You'll get to meet different industry professionals. And finally, it's an awesome opportunity to try out different careers. You'll find out what you like, what you don't like, and maybe you'll find a dream job that you didn't even know existed. Now, let's take a look at your career options. Here are a few of the roles that our environment and business grads have held. Our graduates work both in Canada and abroad, in the public and private sectors. Here's what you need to be admissible to the Environment and Business program. In terms of our admissions requirements, we need you to have a low 80 average in the top 6 U or M courses that you've taken. You'll also need a U-level English course with a minimum of 70%. If you're from outside of Ontario, take a look at our Future Students website for more information about how you'll be assessed. Now let's take a look at our scholarship options. I know I like free money, and I hope you do too. Every student admitted to full-time first-year studies in the Faculty of Environment is automatically considered for the following scholarships. No application is required, but you must accept your offer of admission by the date specified on the offer to remain eligible for these scholarships. If you're a high-achieving student with an 85% average or higher, I encourage you to apply for the following scholarships. The Dean of Environment Scholarship for Excellence is awarded to up to 5 incoming undergraduate environment students. Recipients are based on academic excellence, demonstrated leadership, and a passion for the environment. These scholarships are valued at $7,500. Faculty of Environment Student Engagement Award is available to up to 25 incoming students. Recipients are based on their previous volunteer, leadership, and sustainability-related activities in their communities. These scholarships are valued at $2,000 each. Thanks so much for watching. If you have any questions or concerns, please get in touch with us. We'd love to hear from you. And we can't wait to see you as an environment and business student.